selfish. Taking selfies and only thinking on yourself.
You know, and so much disrespect out in the world. You know, what's wrong with these children nowadays, too? You know, them boys be wearing them pants down to the ground. And, you know, what is this? What's this facial book? Everybody's on Facebook. Yeah, they don't even talk no more. They don't talk no more.
Snapchat.
Snapchat. Yeah. They didn't know. What's that other one?
Thank you.
the thing about it was, even back to the 1800s, back when a slave was here.
Oh, yeah.
But you know, a lot of slaves came in right down that river.
Oh, yeah.
Over there on that Mississippi. They brought, that was where they brought slaves come through there. And they kind of came on out here to the government. And then, you know, a lot of the Indians, you know, a lot of the colors, we don't think that. We think all of Africa. Some of us are Indians. Yes, sir. But we used to pick the cattle and we used to take care of the tobacco and the what is that stuff called? Sugar cane and all that stuff. And you know, let me show y'all something right here. You see this thing right here? I bet y'all don't know what this is. This here is a cat sack. Well, let me say, it's a cotton sack. But you know, we had our own language sack. But this is a cotton sack. What do we do with the cotton sack, you ask me? Well, in the cotton sack, we used to pick this sack and put it around our head, around our neck. Like this.
And this side, come on.
And this side was made to lay on the ground so it can move a little smoother. So then we kind of would pick the cotton, and as we pick the cotton, we put it in the sack.
Yes.
Pick it and put it in the sack.
Yes.
Pick it and put it in the sack. And the more cotton you can pick, the more money you can make. I tell you, sometime, back a long time ago, I think they told me they made, I think it was 50 cents a week. Mm. They was rich back then. Mm. 50 cents a week for picking a lot of cotton.
Oh.
And you know what? We didn't have no lazy children.
No. Oh, no. No.
But nobody lazy.
No.
From the little bitty one to the biggest. Everybody worked. Everybody had chores to do. They would pick cotton, and if you were big enough to pick cotton, you would lay on the sack while your mama or daddy drug you through the field.
Right.
But you were able to learn at an early age how to be something, how to be somebody. What laying around there lazy at the house while your mama them out there working?
No.
No, sir.
Think about pressure.
What pressure
do? Bro, honey, pressure takes 12 children. Right, men? And the Delta, Helena, Arkansas, all 12. Now, all that coke and clean grandma family, they were some wonderful people. They had a lot of charity. They had to have a lot of charity to get that work done.
Oh, that's true.
Come on now. And all of her doctors, lawyers, teachers. Yes. Yes, for the Delta of Arkansas, Helena, Arkansas.
But thank you very much, ma'am.
Yes.
But I'm going to tell you what they had to do. Like she said, her grandpa did. They had to pick that cotton from sun up to sundown.
Yes, sir.
They said, sun up to sundown, picking that cotton. Sun up to sundown, with by the mountain. Sun up to sundown, chain and shackle. No more action, not for me. Oh, sun up to sundown. To tell the story that when you go back to the slavery times,
A lot of little colored folks, little colored children, weren't able to go to school. And then they got to a place where they allowed them to go to school. And they went to school, those children went to school happy to go to school. Sometimes they went barefoot, didn't have no shoes on their feet. Clothes was ragged. But they went to school because they had one goal in common. And that was to get an education. They went through the sun, the rain, the snow, whatever it was. But now let me tell you this. Some of them only went certain times of the year.
Yeah.
Because they had to help in the fields.
Yeah.
So that the family could eat. Little bitty children like that, that had to come together to make the family what it used to be, the family unit strong. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, we were separated.
Uh-huh.
Like I talked about in the washing bottle. But yeah, still, we were connected.
Yes.
You know, I get worried sometimes because I don't think these young folks realize that.
Mm-hmm.
All the stuff that we went through just to be here. I'm looking at in this audience, I'm seeing these kids dressed up in suits and bow ties. So I think they got the stuff together.
Yeah.
But they can tell they're free. But see, that's how they do it down here in heaven. And a key thing that's going to carry you a long way, I want you to listen in. It's a word that begins with R and it ends with T. And it's called respect.
Oh, yeah.
Respect will take you a long way.
Oh, yes.
We need some R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Oh, R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Uh-huh.
I know what it means to me.
Hey.
Respect me. I have to respect you. And we have to respect all of us, each other.
You got some good folks of all colors come from here. And the thing about it is, not only does this area have some of the richest, most powerful soil, it has some of the most richest and powerful people that come from here. Oh, let me tell you something, you think you ain't nothing because you're from the country. Oh, let me tell you, baby. You are somebody.
Yes. All right, yes,
you are. I'm telling you, it's the folks that come out here before you.
Yes.
They come out from harder times than you face.
Yes.
And they come up and amaze some of themselves because they had that determination.
Yes.
They had that drive to keep on moving. And I can tell you what enough. Them folks went through the Civil War.
Oh, yes,
the Civil War was fought right down here.
It was a port city. It was a port town. Helena was a port city.
Right down that river, right around that Mississippi River.
Right on the Mississippi River.
And you know who was down? Who was here, girl? Tell them. You want to talk to them?
No,
I
just want to say that we have Confederate soldiers here, but guess what? Helena had Union soldiers. Union soldiers. The War of 1866 might be 1863. But let me tell you what they did. The Union Army fought the Confederate Army and won when they took Little Rock. I just want to say, I just want to tell that. Oh, and I want to tell one more thing. The Edwardian bed and breakfast, right here, 15,000 soldiers were wounded right where that bed and breakfast is. And I believe I heard something about 2002. They found 6 soldier bodies back behind the bed and breakfast. But they belonged to the Confederate Army. So they dug them up and buried and placed them in the Confederate Army.
Well, it so happened last too. Helena has a lot of good rich history. They have a good rich history. Yeah.
Hope.
Now that makes me think, every time I turn on the TV, I'm seeing a whole lot of violence. And I know some that say war is a part of a whole lot of violence, but y'all, we gotta stop killing one another.
Yes.
Everybody mad, everybody angry, everybody hating one another.
Yes.
But Jesus is love.
Yes.
He's on the main line, so I don't know what I'm so angry about. And y'all got to go to school, get education. You see, that's the key to success. That's something that can't be taken away. How many of y'all love yourselves?
Yeah.
Show your hand.
You love yourself.
That should be to everybody. And if you're not there, I want you to get there. Because if you love yourself, then you'll know how to love your neighbor.
Yeah.
Now see, we had a hard time back then.
Yeah.
Like she said, we went through the Civil War.
Yes,
we did. We went through civil rights.
Oh, yes,
sir. Now we can be civilized, but it's up to us to do that.
That's right. That's right.
And you know, it's a song that we used to sing out there marching on the civil rights.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
And it went something like, ain't gonna let nobody turn me around.
Ain't gonna let apartheid turn me around.
died all that ignorance and came together for one purpose.
Yes.
They put aside all of that foolishness.
Yes.
And came together so that everybody have a right.
Yes.
The same rights and privileges. And I'm going to tell you something. You might start off being ignorant, but don't be ignorant all your life.
Please.
Get your sense somewhere. Because ain't nobody messed up about you. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. And I'm going to tell you one more thing. I'm going to say that. We talking about all these folks getting killed in these streets. Well, if you know how to act in the streets, you won't get killed in the streets. Because most of y'all got sick to stay out the streets. I'm through talking now. I'm through now.
Something like this. These healthy folks, they tell me. songs about the glories of Spring Lane and the tussleness of some tech. That's it with Selma and with Jay. Beefsteaks, fried with onions, and they be seasoned up just fine.
Oh, that sounds like me. But you can just give me some hog meat.
Took care of them kids, and they look good. ladies and gentlemen, the Delta Fashion Queen. Yes, sir.
Come on, now.
Child, look, I'm old, child, and I get tapped guys to the apple. But y'all know something? We could have never made it without our faith. Without a faith in our life. And many times it gets so hard that I can see and hear my own grandmama and that old church house.
Oh, yeah.
You know, they were gathered back before the church house. You know, some folks didn't want them to get together. So they had to go to the brush harbor, which was a bunch of bushes, and they got to have church. But later on, we were able to come into the church house. And I could see her after working all week in the fields. She got so weary and so worn. And she knew she couldn't call on a neighbor because they were tired too. So she looked towards heaven. And she said, precious Lord, take my hand.
By God's grace.
Oh,
yeah.
Lee.
Photographer here back in the 50s, and he captured images of everything, of every aspect of life in the Delta. If you look on those small boards over there, you'll see barefoot kids on a homemade swing set. That's what they had to do. They didn't have what y'all have nowadays. They had to make a swing set out of tree limbs. They had to do what they had to do in order to survive. It wasn't easy back then. And if you see some of these pictures that they're holding up here, these are bales of cotton. Now, they just got through talking about cotton. And they had to pick it by hand. And these bales of cotton right here weighed upwards of 500 pounds.
Ooh,
500 pounds.
That's
and that's the cotton being weighed and recorded. Mm-hmm. And this is a black man who had a truck with his name on the side of the truck.
Wow.
And that cotton belonged to him. His name was Silas Green.
He was rich, wasn't he?
Silas Green, y'all. Silas Green. Cotton weighed, cotton picked right out in them fields out there. Y'all might not know anything about that, but that's what they did. Now, everything he did, he took pictures of. He had pride in what he did. And today, guys, I happen to bring by just a few pictures to show life in the Delta through the lens of my dad, Roger Lee Johnson. And I happen to have today, if you'll let me show it to you, I got the camera that he used.
Oh, what you said? Bro.
Yes, yes. Now, I'm gonna be real nice and gentle with you. But this is the camera that he used back in the 50s. This is not a cell phone. This is a camera. The negatives are size 4x5, and they make these images here. And we can blow them up to billboard size. We've got pictures of baptisms that he did when he's in a boat. Now think about this guy. My dad went to school just like y'all did. He got a scholarship to AM&N over in Pine Bluff. He played football. But he had a hobby, and that was taking pictures. And he pursued his dream. He had a teaching job, but he walked away from that so he could do what he wanted to do, which was take pictures and play music. And I'm here today to show you the results of his success with this camera right here. So be inspired, y'all.
Yeah.
Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up on your hopes. And make something of yourself. Just thought I'd share that with you today.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Just set it on your table.
down in the Delta.
In the Delta, yes, it does.
The Delta, now what is the Delta? Some of y'all don't know what the Delta is.
Yeah.
The Delta is a long, flat land space where people from everywhere came. You can holler from here, clean over yonder, uh-huh. And you come out of your back porch to see your neighbor's house. Now, one thing that kept the Delta alive was the music.
Yeah.
Now, my nephew took it to church early. But let me tell you something. Sometimes we want to have a little bit of love. So we come up with these songs called the Delta Blues. The Delta Blues. The Delta Blues.
Well, she said, I don't mean any harm, but around here,
might need to consider, you know, just going to school for industry. Get you a degree, go to school and work in a factory, or work on the farm. Now, you know what? If I had to believe in myself,
that's right.
Or believe, had further belief in the Creator that He was going to help me, guess what I would be? But I told her, and with all due respect, I said, thank you very much. I said, but I will work in somebody's office. And I'm here to tell you today, I'm old, but I'm going to tell you today, not only did I go to school, I went to college.
Yeah.
I got my degree in education.
Uh-huh.
Then went on to get my master's in business. Oh, I'm telling you that I'm from the Delta. And if I had to listen to them people, I wouldn't be here. So I want, come on. I want to tell y'all this, if you believe. If you believe in your heart, you'll know. Nothing can change the path you must go. Believe what you feel, and know it's right, because time will come around when you say it's yours. Your heart, if you believe, I know you will. Just believe in yourself right from the start. Keep faith and love deep in your heart, and you'll have courage that lasts your whole life.
Hey!
y'all believe better days are coming. Because you know what's going to make the days better is you. You got to turn around this mess out here. Teachers, teachers, you keep on teaching. Teachers, you keep on believing. Children, you get yourself together and keep on learning. Keep on respecting people that love you. And one day you'll grow up and you can be happy. I said you can be happy. You can be happy. And you can grow up and be something one day. Come on, put your hands together. Y'all can join us. Come on. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. So glad you came my way. We came to give you education. Take it out, spread it thin to every nation. Because I'm and a room without a roof. Because I'm and happiness is the truth. Because I'm wrong if you feel happiness is the truth. I don't hear y'all. Y'all know this song, sing it. Listen. Don't bring me bad news talking this and that. I gave you what you need, that is that. Take it home and use what I gave you. And you'll be successful in all you do. Happy, because we're happy. Yeah, we're happy. All cause we're happy. Woo! Lord, we're happy. Somebody help him now. Listen, don't let nothing bring you down. Don't let nothing bring you down. Love is too high to bring you down. Don't let nothing bring you down. Come on, y'all. Happy, 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 happy. Happy, 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 happy. Oh, because I'm happy. Because I'm happy. Come on, y'all, if you know you're happy. Yeah, because I'm happy. Don't let nothing bring you down. Don't let nobody bring you down. Don't you know how bring you down? Keep the grades high, bring you down. Cause I'm happy. Help along if you will. Yeah. Anybody happy? Anybody happy? Woo! Yeah. Yeah. How many of y'all happy that this evening? You might have came in here sad, but you ought to be happy right now. We gave you something to take back with you. We hope that you were inspired, encouraged, and educated about the Delta and some of the things that went on and some of the people, the rich people from the Delta. We want you to know that we are happy that you came back so that we could give you this piece of pie. All right? We are
S1 Young and Artists United. You can find us on Facebook. We are here to share the love all across this land and country, to tell the story, to tell what we went through, how we did it, and who all did it. We want to thank all of the teachers, all of the amazing kids for coming and sharing with us today. Now, I want to introduce you to some amazing people. We have over here, next to me, this is
Rose Davis.
This is Miss Rose Davis, y'all give her some love. Over here we have in Junebug, Warren Booker Jr. the second. Then we have the silky sounds of Miss Leatra, also known as Miss Sue Colburn. All the way from the big city of Brinkley, Arkansas, we have none other than Brother Willie Moore. Then we should go up to Virginia and slide down the slide. You'll see this little lady right here, Michelle Warden. And we have back on these wonderful keys, back over here in the corner, y'all move out the way so they can see. None other than the maestro himself, Mr. William T. Stagger. We also have over here one of our wonderful people that came to share with us in the person of Mr. Johnson. Give it up for Mr. Johnson. Now, we would not be here today, of course, if it wasn't for the Creator, number one, but also for this amazing man who is making a difference in the Delta, from the Delta, through the Delta. Let's give him a round of applause and celebration for Dr. Kyle T. Miller. Now, hold on, wait a minute, hold up, don't give it all away. But I'm one more person. I am your writer, director, and producer of this wonderful piece. My name is Stephen Wanyong. So come on, y'all, let's tap it out. Thank you, and good night.